Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika, Tālo Whakautou. Well, this morning we go back to Samoa, but this time it's for the annual Miss Samoa beauty pageant, which was part of the Te Wila Festival.
That's right. Our reporter John Pulu volunteered to do the story, and we sent him to Samoa. Some people get all the hard jobs, don't they? Here's his search for Miss Samoa 2015.
Clothes?
I'm searching for the next Miss Samoa.
Miss Samoa? No, she's not in there.
Have you ever thought about entering Miss Samoa?
Well, actually, I'm married.
That's a shame. Well, interview over then. No. So why haven't you entered Miss Samoa?
Because I'm old. I'm 28, so yeah.
No way, 28. I thought you were 19.
This was a tough assignment.
Well, I thought maybe it's about time we asked the public what they want in their Miss Samoa. How would you describe the perfect Samoan girl?
Beautiful, respectful.
Good looking. Has to be smart. And a good dancer.
I wonder what size Miss Samoa's feet is. Is it this one? Do you think it's important that Miss Samoa should know how to cook?
Yes. If you want to be a real Samoan, you have to be yourself.
The girls, the ladies are. They always wear like this.
I might need two for me if I had to wear one of them.
Just being able to know who you are and know God, your family, and also your culture.
I still needed some expert advice, and look who I found. No, not Peter Andre, but Petia Vuitavete.
I think the qualities that the girls should have to represent Samoa is the way she walks. She knows how to respect people, and she knows how to get along with everyone. Like, she needs to have the heart to love all Samoan people.
Thankfully, Samoa has chosen six contestants already. They hail from the motherland and abroad.
Hello, palava, ladies and gentlemen.
Aloha, shana lita aloha. I'm 23 years of age.
Maola oa oa sweet salba numero fa.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am Miss Samoa Australia.
I'm your contestant number six. Papsai tere lava.
Okay, I'm down with that, but I felt it was important for me to meet the contestants face to face. As the girls were getting ready for the competition, I could sense their passion.
I'm very passionate about the environment. I studied marine science in uni, so it's just something I'm passionate about.
And is that why you're wearing a green top? Because you're very worried about the environment?
I was selling cocoa when I was little. So for me, I thought that I would never be here.
So I grew up in other Pacific countries. It's always good to come back and just immerse yourself in the real Samoa. You learn about it overseas, but it's never the same as to when you actually come back home.
It's actually an opportunity that I never thought I would actually participate in. But it's something really different to try.
I just want to encourage all the ladies of Samoa, if you can dream it, you can do it.
I'd like to be a voice for young people. I'd like to encourage a healthy lifestyle so we can all be as good as we can be.
And with the magic of television, we fast forward to the main event.
Miss Samoa is really a celebration of that tamaitai Samoa in every sense of the word.
So I used to be a critique of beauty pageants until I ended this journey. And it's such an awesome forum to be able to empower women, it really is.
The beauty queens compete in categories like traditional wear, sarong wear, intense interview, and show off their talent.
Put me in school and to ensure that I was never hungry.
But there can only be one.
your new Miss Samoa. 2015, contestant number 5, Samoa.
Once in a lifetime opportunity, and our island pageants are very different from the Western ones. It's all about embracing our culture and the beauty of our women in every shape and form. So I would definitely encourage it. Don't be afraid. It's mainly about the journey.
There you have it. We've found the most beautiful girl in Samoa.
Very, very tough assignment there.
Yeah, I don't think John was enjoying, you know, doing that story.
It actually makes sense because JP had been getting text messages throughout this week.
Really?
And I was unsure why, but now I think I know who those text messages were from.
Don't want to start any rumours. Thank you, JP, for that story.